want to start to asking you, who is this man, this legend, this animal? Because we can see his journey inside the movie, but do we really know him? I think the most beautiful thing about your character is that he's huge, he's so strong, but at the end, he's so fragile.
Yeah, I think that kind of, you just summed it up. I think that's the essence of the character, that he is a Viking berserker, but deep down he is an abandoned boy who lost his parents and who is just desperately wants to find, be reconnected with his parents. That's his journey in this life or the next, but the idea to be reconnected is important, to have a sense of family, because he's been alone ever since he was 10 years old. And it was important to try to capture that sense of abandonment and loneliness, that he is not connected with another human being since he was a young boy.
It is also a story of a loneliness. He doesn't know how to embrace the change also.
Because he's kind of stuck. When we meet him as an adult, as when he's a berserker, he has lost his way. His fate is set, but he has lost his way. And it's not until that scene after the big raid, the scene with the character played by Bjork, that's when she kind of snaps him to and reminds him of who he is and what his destiny is. And after that, he goes from a state of being almost like a zombie. I think he's just kind of not emotionally connecting with anything around him or anyone. But at that point, he's almost awakened. And after that, he's very determined to conquer his destiny, his fate.
So Robert, I want to start with your quote. Humankind, it seems, never change. Maybe that's why I'm drawn to the past. Is it dark and distant mirror? What did you mean with that? And how did you put that in the movie?
Well...
It's your word.
Yeah, I think I couldn't have said it better myself. I think that, you know, when I'm telling a story that takes place in another period of time, I do a lot of research, and it's exciting for me to be reading about people who are behaving and thinking in ways that are very foreign to me, and then getting so immersed in it that I can say, oh, okay, I understand. If I lived then, I could think that and believe that and act like that. And once I get to that place, then I realize it's still us now. And so, you know, my hope is that through, you know, presenting the past and their worldview without judgment, that that rather than imposing modern morality on a period film by doing it the way I'm doing it, we can hopefully learn more about who we are and where we're going by where we came from, if that makes any sense.
The way you portray these characters with no judgment, it's like you want the audience to judge them. They are just the way they are. Even the most bad one has, you know, his shades. And you can, in some other way, relate to that.
Yeah, that's when I read the Icelandic sagas, the modernity of how of the human, of the people, was what like shocked me. Even though, you know, the Viking code of honor and the cycles of revenge are horrific. You know, the villain, you know, might be a loving father and husband, and the hero might be an outlaw and kind of a psychopath. And that was interesting. And I think, you know, for me, I had to see how the ending of this film is a happy ending for our protagonist, Amleth. But to me personally, it's horrible.